Hey guys, I'm Farrahs and welcome back to another one of my videos. Welcome back to Slime Rancher, the bubbliest game in the world, or the slimiest game in the world. No, that's actually kind of gross. Let's move on. Now, I've showed you guys quite a bit, and there's also an update for this game coming out soon called the Indigo... The Indigo Quarry, which is for version 0.3.0. So a new bit of the map should be opening soon. As you can see, we're currently not in it, so we probably will check that out next week if they've released it. Now, to be fair, I've never gone in here while recording, so I should probably show you guys what this actually is. This is actually our mail, and we can also sleep till morning, but I don't see any point in it, really. So I've got a load of stuff here, and like a load of mail, but to be fair, I'm not sure if I'm interested in reading it or not. Like, this is like one, welcome to the far, far range. Now, this is one of like the first bits of mail you get. So, Ms. Le-bleh-bleh, the 7Z Corporation would like to welcome you to the far, far range and extend our support in your bold new ventures as a slime rancher. We look forward to you supplying us with a steady flow of plots for which we will pay handsomely. Now, there's a pillow in the background, which is a slime, and I'd love that. I'd love to have that. That specific pillow. Like, I know it's all just drawings, but I want that pillow. Now, carrying on. We would also like to request that you exercise caution in your first few days on the range, until you get more familiar with your surroundings. Travelling at night is not advisable. Yeah, I don't care about that, do I? I'm not really too bothered. Lastly, should you... let me get my moisture back. Lastly, should you require any additional tools for your VAC pack, the 7Z Corporation will be pleased to provide them to you from the shop located just outside your ranch house. Good luck to you, Mrs. Blubbs. That's how I'm actually going to pronounce it now. The 7Z Corporation. Welcome to the Range Exchange. Hi there, Beatrix. My name's Farrahs. Like, I don't know who this Beatrix person is, but you got the wrong email. Like, I can send you my updated email, but to be fair, I'm not sure I want to. Carrying on. Hi there, Beatrix. The name's Thora West. I'll keep my introduction short on account that we all got work to do. I'm a long-time rancher here on the Far Far Range and head of the welcome wagon for your local range exchange. This is actually quite a large email. The Range Exchange is a network of ranchers just like yourself who are looking to trade what they got for what they need. Slimes, plots, food, whatever. All you need to do is check out the Range Exchange machine daily and be sure to get your trade completed by noon. So that's the thing where you put in the stuff and it poops out the prize. As more ranchers get added to your network, you should receive a hearty hello from them, so check your inbox. Well, enough jawing. We've both got slimes to wrangle. Adios, Beatrix. Thora. Now, I'm quite tired at the moment, because I've just finished recording World of Madness, and that seems to get me out of breath really well. P.S. Since old Hobson's range exchange link went dead years ago, I assumed he broke the dang thing like everything else on that ranch. I'll bet you have your hands full. In any case, I arranged for another to be shipped to you free of charge. Should have arrived last night, so check it out. So, yeah. I'm curious on what happened to the guy who actually worked there beforehand. Like, this is a second-hand range. Now, I think these emails will actually reveal more to the story as we get along. And I may as well read them out, really. So this one's, salutations, Ms. Le-bleh-bleh. Allow me to introduce myself. I am Victor Humphreys. Wow! Best name 2016. Like, guaranteed. Victor Humphreys. That sounds like what I'm gonna name my kid now. Victor Humphreys Farrahs Bay. His last name's Bay now. I am Victor Humphreys, professional slime rancher, slime scientist, and amateur musician. Okay, that's quite clever. My understanding is that Miss West has already informed you of how the range exchange works, so I will spare you any further education. It sounds like the music's getting louder the more I read. Instead, I'll illuminate you on what you can expect from my own requests. As a slime scientist rancher, I have a tremendous interest in the liquiform legion that we share this vast range with. The slimes. Oh, the liquiform... Oh, did I say region or legion? I don't even know. My studies often keep me from venturing out on the range daily, and when I find myself short of a particular species, I use the range exchange to fill that gap. Don't worry though, I will reimburse you handsomely for your efforts. Good luck in your new venture, Miss Le-bleh-bleh. I look forward to seeing life breathe once again into the former Twilgers Ranch, which was the guy beforehand. Sincerely, Victor Humphreys. P.S. I once lost my favourite fiddle while fleeing a feral boom slime. Its value is only sentimental, but should you find it, it's very much love to be able to play it again. I'd very much love to play build. Oh, is that like a... Can I actually find that? I should have read these sooner. There's still two more, and I can't be bothered to read them. But, you know... Yeah, forget it. I'm not reading them. Right. I'll read the next two next time. But I'm now curious on what... Is this an actual thing? Can we find that fiddle? Like, I'm dead interested in that now. Like, I really hope I can actually find it. Somebody's going to probably Google it for me and go, no, you can't find it. But if it turns out you can actually... Look how much bloody plorts there are. Because they just... I'd leave them to just fester. Jeez. Like... But the thought of being able to go in and actually collect... Like, find something... That's going to be really cool. I really want to find this now, this fiddle. I'm curious on if like a slime's eaten it. It said it was, he lost it after getting attacked by a feral boom slime. Now they're only actually, the boom slimes only appear in one place. So finding it shouldn't be too hard. I say one place, it's in the oh no. Do you know what I bet it is? Right, since we do actually have an update coming out soon that probably ties in with that a bit. So it might turn out that it's in the Indigo Quarry. It all depends on where, which creatures spawn where. Because to be fair, I really hope the Indigo Quarry actually opens up the ability to get a new type of slime, which is the green ones. The what do they call them? I can't even remember what the slimes are called. They're called Erms. They're called the green slimes. I can't remember what they're called. The radioactive sort of slimes, the ones with the pulsating ring around them. Now, I'd love to get a few of them. I think that would be actually... That's kind of what I might want to do. Like, I really hope that the Indigo Quarry opens up that possibility of being able to... I love the art style on this, by the way. This game is fantastic for art. I'm going to get this guy. Come on, mate. Alright, so we got a puddle. We've got a puddle slime. So we're actually going to use this... Oh. Oh, I got stuck on a cat. Stupid tabby. Bad tabby. You know what you... I've got a lot of... Like, all these slimes I don't need to really get, like, be bothered or anything about because... Oh! Right. So while I'm here, I'm gonna... Right, so... I've got a load of pogo fruit. I also want to try and get myself... some of that... Some of the sweet mint stuff. I'm not entirely sure what it's called. I've completely forgotten. It's gone away from my mind. But I'd love to be able to... Oh, these are normal. I thought these guys were going to be angry at me. They're not. They're fine. I can't remember what I was saying. I've lost track of what I was talking about. Ah! Oh, you little git! Oh. I'm not... Right. I know I'm going to seem like a total wuss bag now, which is fine, I am, so, but I was not expecting that, okay? all that was going through my head then was, oh look, stuff, but nope, I got face attacked, I got face attacked by a big-ass slime. I'm gonna get some of these. Ah, go away! I'm gonna get some briar hens, I think. Oh, there's another stony hen there. Oh well. Oh yeah, I'm gonna grab some of these briar hens, because they're kind of overpopulating at the moment. I'll also grab you. Thank you. Where are they coming from? No! You stay away from him, you meanie pants! Aww, I wasn't able to save him, I don't think. But yeah, like, I'm genuinely shocked by what just happened, by those slimes. Like, they just was like, yep. Oh, he survived! Like, I wasn't expecting a slime to just be, like, in my face like that. Going. He's still here. Oh, but he's in the water, so. Oh, piss. Alright, I'm gonna go back, get some briar hens. And look, they produce so much on their own. Like, if you, most of the time, you would not actually have to do anything in this game, because a lot of it's done by the AIs in the slimes, which is actually, it's got some really clever design and stuff behind it. Okay, there we go. I've got a little briar head in there. Oh! Ah! God damn it. I've watched so much brutal massacre of, like, small defenseless chickens. Oh, that hit me. That hit me hard. Ow. But yeah. Like, 1 minute you'd just be standing there staring at a slime, and then suddenly he'd just full on devour a chicken as if it was nothing. Just. Mmm, delicious. So, there is an image up of the Indigo Quarry, apparently, because I can see it on my, like, I can just see it on the Steam, on the side of my Steam page of what's going to be happening for me. Yeah. Okay, so. It's not all of them. Come on, there we go. I think I've got more? Yeah, I got more. Sweet. Ow. Ouch. Right, so I think I've got enough money that I can actually start to organize getting myself these. So we want to get, for puddle slimes, you want to get a pond. The ponds basically have a load of water in them, and you literally just place the slimes in. Now, oh wow, those water physics are screwing up. Ah, help, there we go, I'm out. Sorry about that, my phone went off. Like, I'm not used to having phone calls, gonna be honest. I'm not actually sure if I want to answer it or not, because it's an unknown number. Could have just answered it and said, hello, Belper Sex Line. I live in a town called Belper, by the way. So, I've actually answered the phone with that on multiple occasions. Didn't realise who it was in the end, but, you know. YOLO! Eat my pleaties! Oh, I just realised I could have probably fed those rock plots. Oh well, these rock slimes, sorry. Oh, and the boom slimes. I completely forgot about these guys. Oh well. You know, you sneeze, you lose, stupid slimes. Right, so I've got quite a bit of money now. I think I've pretty much actually just got made all my money back from I might just have to suck up the tabbies as well, because otherwise I can't really, there you go, okay, it's clear. There we go. So I'll quickly cash them in. And now we've got, we have now 2,000 coins. So that's good. And so we got the, to be fair, I bet I know what it is, because recently I've been getting a load of phone calls, from web development companies. I am a web developer, by the way, but it's because I bought a few URLs so I can test some of my stuff on, and it's just made them. I'm just gonna buy all of these, I think. So these actually, so yeah, so I've now actually bought myself a jetpack, so I can actually go out and venture into places. Oh yeah, by the way, so on with what these guys actually do. So you can actually shove water slimes and puddle slimes into a pond, and they'll automatically produce their plots without needing to actually feed them. So, but this water level does actually drop low, but it does also have the possibility to refill. Like, you can go out, suck up some water and shoot it into this pond. But you don't want the water level to get too high. Because if it does, then your slimes can jump out. And if they jump out, they could evaporate and die. So you don't want that to happen. You want to avoid trying to do that at all costs. Look how many plots are around. Jeez. Oh, I forgot about these guys. I forgot about the phosphor slimes. I completely forgot these guys existed. That sounded like a turkey just got... Not turkey, a rooster just got eaten. My neighbours have got chickens, by the way. Like, my neighbour... Like, I came out one day and all I heard was... I was like, what the hell is that? I turned around, there's a cage next door and it's got a couple, like, three or four chickens in it. The thing is, I wasn't sure if they had a rooster or not. Because, like, in a residential... Like, I think they're my old neighbours. Like, I think my... Because I've just recently had a neighbour move. And I think... Because they moved... Oh, I forgot I had a jetpack then. Whee! Yeah. Because my neighbours... One of my neighbours has moved, I've ended up... My actual neighbours, the ones that are on my side, ended up buying the chickens off them. So, we ended up with neighbours with chickens. Right, so what have we actually got? We still got this slime. This Gordo slime. So we're actually going to fill it up with... we need a load of chickens. Lots and lots of chickens. I think I know the best place to actually go to get that. I can hear that there's bad slimes out. Oh, actually, do you know what I can do? Right, since I've got this jetpack now. Right, so what you can do is there are little pathways, like hidden pathways that you guys, which you can actually explore and go up if you know how to get there. Stop killing everyone, you bunch of... Oh my god, these guys have multiplied massively. Right, okay, there we go. Woo! God, these guys are vicious. Right, so yeah, there's multiple pathways you can actually look into. So this is one of the pathways. This pathway actually leads you up to a different route entirely. Aw, stony chickadoo. Bye-bye. Oh, God, look. It's so vicious. I understand that the... What is it? The big evil slimes. These ones. They're pretty much like janitors, and they're a cleanup crew, really, and they get rid of the slimes when there's too many of them. But you just gotta be careful that they don't decide they want to eat you, because otherwise you end up dead. You will die. I think I'm gonna also start a henery. What do they name them? All right. So we've got. Let's get a few hens and roosts. Like I've got. Two roosters, so this should actually help provide a proper thing. I gotta show you guys some of this stuff which happens, because they properly went into full design with these, I've got no space. More than four! I need more than four. I'm a Minecraft player. I'm used to 9 slots and just being able to scroll through and select them. This is weird for me. I need 9 slots or else I'm gonna die. Right, so let's get this on. So we want to get a coop. Okay, whatever you say, kiddo. So we're going to throw them in there. We're going to throw a hen in there. And we're going to throw these stony hens in there. And we're going to see what upgrades we can get for them. So we can get high walls, which might be an idea to actually get, because these are going to drive me insane. Like, I remember the chickens. I remember the chickens from my... I can't even remember what I was saying. I've completely lost track of it because I was too busy thinking of chickens. Did I not feed you all? Here, have some food, my darlings. Oh, yes, produce me some lovely, lovely foods. Okay. Oh, okay. I thought the stocks had, like, completely dropped massively then. They don't seem to have gone too bad. Like, when they start to actually fall massively, then I'm going to start to worry. Ooh, 18 of these. Jeez, I didn't even know that. Right, so we've got the lag killers, the annoying sound makers, the overly energetic ones, because you've got the, like, pony slimes, which are a bit of an arse. And then you've just got those big bastards in there. Big buggers. I did not swear then. You can't prove anything. So we've got high walls. Let's get a... Let's get spring grass as well. So this, we've actually now got our coop in. There we go. That's nice and good. That's... Oh, look! Go on, back in. Oh, I also got some water by accident. There we go. Now, I just saw... Oh, right, okay. So basically, I've just noticed that. Okay. Because these puddle plots are, like, they're literally water... and if you fire one, like, if you miss, it will explode into water. So basically, if you leave this, this pond will actually just pretty much rejuvenate itself if you end up forgetting about stuff. So you don't have to worry about this one, really. I think you'll be fine. You also can't merge these with anything. So yeah, these are, like, completely different, like, ways of being a slime. But I think that's pretty much all we've got time for today. So thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed. Remember to leave a like, subscribe, and leave a comment. And tune in next time for more Slime Rancher! Also, get the game on Steam if you've not yet got it. It is fantastic, it's adorable, and you will love it. And this constantly updating because it's such a new game. So thanks for watching, guys. See you next time. Bye.